Karen and
Ben.
So we're streaming together, obviously, today. Ben is going to review some games that he thinks are important in chess history for all of us to make sure we know about. And I'm going to, it's the usual format, though. I'm going to play viewers. Ben's going to do the lesson. Oh, well, Ben will also tell us, give us tips on our games, you know, in between then the lesson, then I'll play more viewers. Then we're out of here. That's the format. Now let's see if we have anybody yet. It takes a while. That's why we need the intro videos.
What I do?
You didn't do anything.
Yeah, you refreshed.
Yeah, but I mean...
Now you have a lot of
views. Right? There's one, and it's probably me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I thought you were watching somebody else's stream. Yeah, I didn't get notified yet.
Okay. Well, we can just hang out for a minute.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, Perrier. Mm-hmm. I like this stream. It has Perrier.
Yeah. While we're waiting on people to get here and to show themselves... Mm-hmm. And
yeah, I'm gonna have to use another window to bring up some of the games later. Yeah, like that one.
Yeah, we can get as many windows as you want.
Yeah, just one. Yeah, just one gun fox.
Okay. Well, while we're waiting on people, what I wanted to do so I don't mess up my window here is I'm just
doesn't it kick you off of chess.com when you open another chess.com? So it does to me.
No. It does get confused sometimes, and mm-hmm. if it thinks that I'm in live chess, which I'm not. But I have had, you can be anywhere on the site, but live chess once. But it gets confused. Mm. And sometimes it thinks my phone, it's counting my phone, like which right. I don't even know it's logged in. Yeah. So, yeah, it's kind of tricky. Mm. But, yeah, it'll let me do this as you watch today. Mm-hmm. But that's a good question you asked. Mm-hmm. And I'll go to here because I just wanted to look real quick. See what's going on.
Yeah, they should put Spencer in that as the referee or something.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, presented by Panda. Now, Panda just signed somebody. Who was it? Was Anna it Anna Kremling? Yeah. Okay. Well, that's kind of cool. Mm-hmm. Let's see. Smasher's Gambit. Well... I wonder...
And now we have two viewers. We doubled our viewership. How did we do that? Wow.
I mean, we have a lot of competition.
We have competition?
Hikaru's streaming right now.
Who?
Botez is streaming.
Which one?
Gotham Chess is streaming. Hey, Cathal Boss, how's it going?
He's the boss.
Chess Queen is streaming.
Who?
Nemo's streaming. Who is not streaming?
Who's Nemo? Is that like Nemsco?
Yeah.
And Hector Laramie, he doesn't come to my stream anymore. I guess he just hangs out at your
stream. Hey, Hector Laramie. No, he comes to your stream. Mm-mm. I don't see him over here much. Hey, he sensed that you were here.
That's what happened.
He sniffed you out. Mm-hmm. Hey, Bishop Takes.
I did take a shower so he could smell something.
Oh, yeah, I'll tell you about poker, Julian. Hey, how's it going? Hey, Felix Frias, thank you for that sub. Yeah, Ben is a surprise.
I wonder if I got notified. Oh, I did.
So, poker night, let me tell.
Hey, you're streaming.
Oh, it's fine. Okay. So, I went last night to, I have two poker things I'm going to be attending, but maybe not now. One was I met a woman at karaoke who turns out plays poker. Anyway, she had ladies poker night last night. Hey, Maxie. Hey, Alpine.
It's funny because when I met a woman at karaoke, Karen got mad.
Yeah. And anyway, the poker, you know, I would say that I'm already past the usefulness of that group for poker. I mean, I'm not going to learn how to play poker doing that group. That's what I would say, Julian. So Ben and I are going to go up next Thursday to... what's it called?
Cherokee
Casino. But it was fun to do it. It's fun to meet some other women that are interested in poker. But, you know, if you're not using some real money, people don't really bet in a way, in a correct way, that's going to help me learn how people are going to really bet. Anyway, I hear all these blips, so that must be some challenges. Let me shut this. Didn't even get to read much news. Well, I do play viewers, and I've got quite a few challengers. So if you want to play GG, Timmy, Simp.
Man, Kangaroo challenging rated. Man, he showed you.
Yeah, no, he puts some, he's got some balls. Thank you, Kangaroo, for doing rated. So he's going to put his rating points on the line because he knows. He knows even though I'm low rated.
His other handle on chess.com is D's Nuts. That's why
he's got balls. He knows I can take some points now. You know it. See, he's got some balls. So, Phil Gordon's Little Green Book is a great, easy reader for beginner. Well, that's a nice recommendation. I might have to check that out, Actor Laramie. Because I'm not trying to be a professional, but I just want to get decent. All right, I'm going to play a game. We'll continue to chat and play.
There's no chess on the internet? Man.
Who is that male model?
Which one?
How is it that everybody knows you're on the stream? Well, I did put Ben as part of the stream title.
Ooh. Probably they can see me. Yeah, you could mail it to us at the Chess Center, Laramie, if you'd like.
What's he doing, mailing?
Mm-hmm. He's going to mail the book.
Oh, you're going to get it for me. Well, thank you.
No, he has it. He's read it a lot.
Oh, okay. You're going to lend it to me.
He said it only has a little COVID on it. So.
Well, that's sweet, though. I can borrow it. Mm-hmm. It's no reason for me to buy. Now, let me pay attention for a second. Because I'll do that. I don't know what to do. I'm just going to do this.
Hey, you have 95 viewers, it says. I wonder if that's a lie.
Mm-hmm. I don't know how much to believe.
Somebody asked what your favorite book was that wasn't a chess book.
Well, I don't have a favorite book. But... I really love that book, though, by Willa Cather called My Antonia. I love that book. And I love Ian McEwan. He's a British author. Love him. Saturday was really good.
Yay, 106 viewers.
Yay. Hey, Avisor, how's it going?
I wonder how many are people.
Yeah.
Ooh, Perrier. Frankly. Delicious.
Frankly.
Have you read O Pioneer's Exclam by Willa Cather?
I did not read that one.
Oh, no, you didn't?
Now, let me see.
Yay, it's SK World Guts. No, we lost viewers.
We did? Mm-hmm. Well, it could have been like inflated from like a brief embed.
Lousy Democrats.
Also, I think Twitch doesn't, it's not very accurate.
Mm-hmm. What's that, tickle Karen? Okay.
No, and already, what? You know.
Well, they told me to. Oh, wait, that said, hi, Karen. I misread it.
All right, it's hard to go over here.
Mm-hmm. Still a theory.
Darn, I didn't see that move.
When they say I'm sexy, I wonder if they're thinking of fat bastard. Probably. Ben does not like to share his feelings. She is your wife, Ben. Give her a kiss. Not gonna kill you. What if she kills me?
I'm trying to play some chess. I mean, I need to be kissed right now. God.
I mean. It's her favorite song, too.
I mean,
and her favorite group.
Hard to make a move already. You tickle, don't need to be kissed. Mm-hmm. You know. Need to play faster.
Yeah, fix your audio settings, Laramie. You always play King B1. And also, you always played F3, so that's good.
Frosty's always giving me the beatdown.
Frosty, the beatdown.
just what he does.
He's giving you a frosty reception. I asked Frosty why that was his handle, and he said he works at Wendy's.
Yeah.
Boo, this isn't Spencer. Spencer's days off are Monday and Thursday, so he doesn't come into work then.
Yeah. All right.
Spencer's band every Monday and Thursday. That's
right. Sounds like phone. Oh, is there a ding? Let me move my phone. A phone does interfere with the microphone sometimes.
What about my phone over there? It's pretty far.
You know, not likely. Well,
frankly, not likely. Thing is not touch wood.
True. I couldn't figure out something to do, and I'm low on time. So, per usual.
Yay, 69 viewers.
Yay. Good enough.
Mm-hmm. Gronk would be proud.
Yeah, Frosty needs to.
I look older than Spencer.
I mean, I'm just going to move at this point. All right, GG Frosty.
I'm wondering if Rook H6 check is a three-time repetition. No, it's not. Close.
Yeah.
All right. Oh.
No, Rook was hanging. Listen, I was just trying to move.
This is my game with Komsky from Atlanta a few years ago. I think he played Bishop E2 there. Yeah, this is all good. Yeah, okay. So that piece sack isn't sound. Probably if your bishop was here, it would be fine, but your bishop's blocking your queen, so you don't get enough compensation. Although, you did get enough compensation, I think. He made a very bad move soon.
Okay.
Yeah, in this position, he made a very bad move. Now, it is possible you do have enough compensation, but I don't think so. I probably should play knight f6. Yeah, when he played f5, he opened the diagonal to his king.
Mm-hmm.
So you play bishop c4 check. He doesn't really have a good response to that.
Yeah, I thought about it later, but then he did have a response.
Right, he has to play rook f7. Then you play queen h5, and you should be fine there. And you could play like knight f3, knight g5. So that should be fine. He played here, and then this looked right. Yeah, and you can't trade queens because you're down a piece attacking. So probably you play queen g6. I mean, you're losing here because you don't have enough compensation for a piece. And what's funny is you probably shouldn't castle queenside just because of knight g4 and your f2 pawn is hanging.
Yeah, that did become a problem. Frosty wants to know how he could defend instead of f5.
Well, I mean, as I said, I think knight f6 is the right move. I mean, for example, if black plays rook e8 and the king has the f8 square, I don't know what white's supposed to do. White doesn't really have a lot of attacking pieces. I mean, if the king goes to f8 after some h7 check. But I think knight f6 makes sense because it stops bishop h7 and it stops queen h5. You know, white just doesn't have enough attacking pieces. The problem with f5 is it opens up the diagonal to the king. So, I mean, I'd probably play knight f6 here. Yeah. And then, yeah, trading queens is like sort of like giving up because you're just down a piece now. And then, yeah, f3 is bad because you're allowing the knight to go to e3. Yeah, I mean, down a piece, but okay, probably just take this and bishop c4 check. Something like that.
Okay.
Because now you lost another pawn. And then, in this position, bishop e3 was a good move. Yeah, this loses another piece, but you have no time on your clock. And as the gawking rabble pointed out, the rook on h6 is hanging, but okay, you have seconds. Yeah. So that was, you know.
Yeah, he was on time too.
Your piece sacrifice wasn't necessarily sound, but that doesn't mean that I wouldn't play it in a blitz game.
Yeah.
I wouldn't play it in a slow game.
I think for me, it's good to try those kinds of things because I tend to be tentative and passive anyway, and it can doesn't matter if it doesn't work on the blitz. Mm-hmm. I need to get a tissue, so I'll be right back.
Do you have an issue? Yeah.
No.
I do not.
Da-da-da-da. 74 viewers ado. Mm. Yeah.
All right, well, that was fun.
All right, thanks for watching, everybody.
Hey, it looks like my mouse is about to run out of juice.
Yeah.
Let me get the cord.
Okay. We should get 999 viewers. I think 99 would be good. It's freezing in Pennsylvania. Well, it's a good thing we're not in Pennsylvania.
99. Yeah, which part of Pennsylvania?
It's not freezing inside, I hope.
I miss Pennsylvania, but I don't miss the cold. Mm-hmm. It's cold here, though.
Yeah.
See if you can, I guess, plug it in where that one was plugged in.
Ketchup? Catsup.
Green on the, yeah, that's the right way.
Yeah. I'm from Erie.
Erie.
Is it scary there? Is it freezing inside? Man, you guys need to call your, power company. Yeah, terrible.
Homomorphic says, I just got a call from Rwanda Country Code, and it turned out it was the Canadian government making sure that I'm quarantining.
Probably it was the Hotel Rwanda. I saw that at the Toronto Film Festival, and Don Cheadle was in the audience.
Mm.
I almost asked him a question, but too nervous.
Yeah.
Yeah, because Don Cheadle.
Yeah, that's... I wouldn't have thought you'd get nervous.
Don Cheadle.
It's Don Cheadle.
Yeah.
He looks, you know who he looks a little bit like?
Don Cheadle?
Yeah.
No.
Nick from karaoke.
Yeah.
Doesn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, a little bit. I just never noticed the resemblance. It is a glass Coke bottle, and I can taste the difference. That is my favorite way to drink Coke, is in a glass bottle. Let's see. Latin markets always sell the glass bottles with real sugar. I gotta get one more tissue. Well, I...
Probably not real sugar. Yeah. Oh, sorry.
Hmm?
My nose is all itchy.
And Kieran's crying because she lost that game.
All right, I'm back in. Okay, let's play another one. And then we'll do the lesson soon, maybe after I do one or two more games. Ben's going to go over some games that every chess player should know.
Go glucose, that's correct. Hey, Buzzard Bait.
Hey, Buzzard Bait.
This looks like my game with Kangaroo.
Mm-hmm. Yeah?
Yeah, I played him yesterday on the stream. Except our game was unrated. Did you ever see someone cry at the board? Many, 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 many times.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. That's pretty common. Mm-hmm. Usually children. I have never cried at the board. Oh, when you run out of beer?
Yeah.
That's true, Buzzer Bait. I think I saw you posting today on Facebook buzzer bait. But I will agree that that is common with scholastic chess. Mm-hmm. Oh, Epicenko cried.
Esipenko.
Oh, and I always get it backwards. Esipenko. Let me see which way I should take.
Yeah, one time I saw Esipenko crying because he had a crummy position. Yes.
Crummy. I
wonder if anybody in the chat got that.
Esipenko. What does that have to do with crumb? Is there like the crumbs?
I said Esipenko.
Esipenko.
Penko.
Penko.
There you go. C.L. Smith got it.
What? Yeah. That's what I said. I was about to say the breadcrumbs. Mm-hmm. I thought it was. I got it.
Mm-hmm. Oots, 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 oots. When I was a kid in Michigan, there was a Class A player named Frank Fricko.
Mm-hmm.
And I used to say my pal Benko and my friend Fricko.
Thank you for that donation, Ayadzi.
$10.
Yay.
Holla holla. It's the Don Cheadle variation, that's right.
John Cheadle variation.
Welcome to the Hotel Rwanda.
Man, they are jamming next door. Can you guys hear the music?
Oons, oons, oons. Yeah, when Karen and I go next week to play poker, they're giving us free hotel room because I'm a grandmaster. Something like that.
Yeah, I can't wait to go play some poker.
And then we reserved we have a reservation at Ruth's Chris Steakhouse.
Mm-hmm.
I got confused. I thought it was called Ruth's Chris Vegan House. My bad. Buzzard Bait says I was singing your favorite Roy Orbison last night. That's
hey, Pinky Jim. Yeah, the mild thudding. Well, Roy Orbison, what were you singing?
Probably Pretty Woman, but it was because somebody said something. I don't know what. I think they said I was pretty or something. Something like that.
Yeah, I don't really care for his... He has too much vibrato, in my opinion. That's what I don't care for.
Yeah, Roy Orbison tried to get a free hotel a few years ago at this casino, and they told him he couldn't. And he said, if that's the way it must be, okay.
Oh, that seemed bad for a minute. Okay, I should go. Well, I was worried about like, G5. But I have this protection, so I guess it was fine.
Yeah, and the G pawn's pinned. Etc.
Mm-hmm.
Roy Orbison was crying at the chessboard. know, whenever somebody mentions Roy Orbison, which is pretty rare, I think of the Rick and Morty episode where Rick took Roy off the grid. He doesn't even have a social security number.
Yeah, I don't like it. He sounds very old-fashioned. I don't know. I just don't know why. He reminds me of Gordon Lightfoot, my other favorite. And in both the situations, I don't care for the vibrato. That's the issue.
You're asking me if I saw an episode of Rick and Morty? You're banned in your children's children. That's Karen's favorite musical style, snake jazz. Right, sweetie?
I can't even think about what that might mean.
Ooh, Karen played C4. That's explosive. What do I see? Is her pawn on B3? Yes. Her pawn's on B3. Ooh. Never play F6. Draw by reputation.
Darn. That's terrible.
It is.
Yeah.
Da 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 da.
GG Kangaroo. I don't know why I did that.
Let's see. Matthew Escalin gifted a sub. Hooray.
Hey, Pam.
It's Pam.
Thank you for the gift sub. Yeah, I was just mad for a second.
Go, Pam.
I just don't think very well when it gets... And I had more time. Wow.
All right, so that was a good game. No mistakes by either side. Yeah, I would play more aggressive, like Bishop B5 or Queen B3.
Spencer likes me to... Well, not in this exact position, but he likes me to play bishop b5, but he doesn't... He likes it better when the c-pawn hasn't been moved yet.
Mm-hmm.
So I didn't know.
Yeah, it's even better here because queen a4.
Okay.
All right, and it's just equal and boring.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you always take with the e-pawn, so that's right. That's good. Yeah, all these moves are good. Rook c1 is a strange move. You're not going to move any of these pawns. So you could play rook to e1. You could play knight f3. Probably rook e1.
Hey, Ralph. How's it going?
Yeah, then you took that. You played there. That's good. And then I wouldn't take that because you have this, you know, you have a lot of stuff here.
Well,
so,
okay.
So you play like rook e1. Yeah. That would be good. Okay.
I was just trying to open the diagonal for my queen.
It's just equal. Probably I would take with the bishop. Because he doesn't have a lot of counterplay here. You know, his pawn structure is pretty good. It's still about equal. Yeah.
Here I was worried about G5.
Right, G5 doesn't threaten. I mean, that's not... Yeah, he's not going to play G5. Okay. I would play rook here to play rook here. Because if he takes your A pawn, you have bishop H6, which is why he played queen C4.
But if he did do G5, what would I play?
You could either move your bishop, but in my instance, because I'm playing here, I would play rook D4.
So it wouldn't matter because if then, I double the pawn. Okay, wasn't a big deal then.
Yeah, sorry. But I wouldn't... I mean, I'm playing here, so okay. I'm threatening this. So G5 just loses to rook D4.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Because I want to play bishop H6.
I thought about doing a rook.
And your move is okay. Yeah, because you force him over here.
Yeah.
And then I definitely wouldn't trade queens, but I wouldn't play queen E3 because he has a dark squared bishop. So I'd play queen F3 because he just attacked your queen. Okay, then you play queen F3. That's fine.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, and I wouldn't take his queen because you're opening up the file for him. And if I did take his queen, I would try to win that e-pawn. I guess you can just win the e-pawn. Well, so maybe taking the queen is right because you can just win the e-pawn. You only take the queen if you can win that e-pawn. So in this position, the only question is whether rook e1 works. I think it works.
Mm-hmm.
Play rook e1, attacking his e-pawn. Then I guess he can play rook d3, and you can play c4 again. Yeah, so it's probably a draw. He has rook c3 and rook c2. But yeah, the only reason you would... And then if you're not going to take the pawn, c4 is anti-positional. You're making his bishop better because his bishop doesn't have access to these squares, or his rook, and then you play c4. Mm-hmm. So if you're not going to win this pawn, which is what I would try to do, your next goal is to put your king on e2, which you did do later. So I would play king f1 to e2. So that way your king is controlling all these squares.
Right, okay.
And it's not pinned. So c4 is not a good move. I'm going to keep doing that. So that's good. Okay, h4 is good. Yeah, and then when you played f6, you should just ignore that. Because if he takes on e5, you take with the bishop, and he has these double isolated pawns. So just play king e2. Taking's okay. You stick with the king anyway. And then this is good. And this is an interesting position because I don't know what the right move is. It could be what you did is right. I guess you could also play bishop c7 because you're attacking his rook and the a pawn. So this could be more aggressive.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, and then here, I think you're worse but drawing. And you could play rook d1 here. You probably should play rook d1 because your rook is very, very passive here. You can't do anything. So trading rooks is probably better than having a passive rook, and he has a good rook. Then you can't do anything, but it's hard for him to do anything also.
Well, he was real low on time, right. So I felt like it was the right strategy in a blitz game. To try to win on time. That's all I was trying to do.
It is, yeah. Right.
I know, but I'm just explaining my passive rook move.
Yeah. And then, yeah, when you're trying to win on time, you gotta, as you said, move to different squares. And you should play bishop c7 because you're attacking this pawn. Yeah. This pawn's not easy to defend.
I don't know why. I didn't think it was three yet. I just lost track.
Right. Yeah, because the first two times you played here and the third time you played here.
Yeah, I was just trying to do nothing at that point.
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
But I don't think anybody was ever winning that game. I don't think black's winning here. Black is probably better here. But probably not much.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that was a pretty solid game with a lot of trading.
Yes. Kangaroo.
And then he played sort of slow.
Says it was 0.4 at the end there.
Yeah.
Very close. Yeah. GG.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Kangaroo's slow for his age and rating.
You mean like in the head slow or plays chess slow?
But
can he be both? Yeah.
Solid, boring, slow. That's true, but I'm trying to get faster.
Okay, so do you want to play another game or we'll do what I'm supposed to do?
I think let's go ahead and do the lesson.
Buzzard Bait says 100 centidues.
Yay, thank you, Buzzard Bait. Yeah. So we're going to go into Ben's lesson now where he's going to talk about some games we need to all know about.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Should I put the names of the players?
Yeah, boo. Definitely prefer that.
Boo. You type faster. Morphy.
Really? Okay.
Were you right there? I'm supposed to type.
But I don't ever know how to spell anything.
Morphy. Okay. Then you could put, Count and Duke.
Okay, so this is a opera or Count and Duke?
Uh-huh.
Like that?
Yeah.
Good enough?
Yeah, there you go. What's that thing between the Count and Duke? What's that thing in the middle?
An and?
Well, it's ampersand. It's a Family Guy joke.
Mm.
Mm. Yeah, and then you're supposed to make fun of me for not knowing what it is. Come on. Is it 100 centidues or 100 centidues?
I used to have it memorized.
Mm-hmm.
I don't anymore.
Yeah. Anyway, you got to watch the Family Guy episode. Yeah. Okay. So E4, E5, Knight F3. Now, in this position, Black played what's known as the Philidor defense. What move did Black play here?
D6.
That's correct.
I do know the Philidor, but barely.
Yeah. So higher-rated players always play D4, and lower-rated players usually play Bishop C4. And very low-rated players play Bishop B5 check. Mm-hmm. And when I was teaching chess to kids in schools, Bishop B5 was usually accompanied by checkmate, and their opponent would be like, all right.
Yeah,
so,
they're ready to be done.
Yeah. Okay, now at the grandmaster level, Black has a couple of moves here. Knight D7 is probably the best. And you could also take on D4. And Knight F6 has a bad reputation now. And that happened after Joan Jett got famous.
I see. I love rock and roll.
No.
I'm coming up with nothing.
Yeah, bad reputation.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay.
I saw my Joan Jett.
Okay,
knowledge.
So they played this move, which doesn't fare very well. And what's funny is there was a game played in St. Louis in 2010-ish between Mike Kummer and Tony Rich. And they followed the Morphy game, which went like this.
Mm-hmm. Welcome, Pescatel.
And in this position, Mike Kummer improved on the losing knight F6. He played either Queen E7 or Queen F6, I forgot. And he ended up winning the game against Tony, even though Tony's like 300 points higher rated. Yeah.
Go come on.
Okay, so Knight F6 is a mistake, which loses the game. And now White has a winning move, which I'm sure you'll remember and find. What did White play in this position?
Is this where they swing the queen across town? Or not yet? I don't remember.
Well, you got to say the move.
Well, let me look at it for a minute then. I don't remember this game. I don't know. Queen B3?
Yeah. So when somebody moves their bishop, this pawn is often undefended.
Right.
As was the case when this bishop went here, except the queen's defending the pawn. So, yeah. And as I've shown many times, This reminds me of a trap that I've played a couple times, and the note boom variation named after Mr. Variation. Mm-hmm. Okay, and the move order doesn't necessarily matter, but you get this position. So knight F3 and E3 and E4 are the three common grandmaster moves. I often play bishop F4, which again has a bad reputation. And then we get this variation, and here, the correct move is probably queen b6, as was played against me by Bagirov in the tournament where I beat Gelfand.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but bishop b4 is a known mistake. Takes, queen f3, threatening the rook. So queen d5 is forced, right? And then I keep taking this, but chess.com doesn't let me because it has some software bug.
Mm-hmm.
So then you play queen g3, and this is the same thing that Morphy did, but it's the other side of the board. It's because the queen's threatening this pawn.
Oh, yeah.
And then the queen and bishop are threatening over here. So now White's winning. I've had this position twice in slow chess. And this is the same thing. The queen is threatening here, and the queen and bishop are threatening here. Now, turns out this threat is more potent because white can follow up bishop takes f7 check with queen e6 mate. So that's important to stop. And I was giving a simul at the chess club in the mall, which has moved like four times since, all the King's Men Chess Club. And one of my opponents in the simul played here. So then I won. Yay. And so forth. Okay, but Morphy's opponents played queen e7. And this is an important position in the game because several things are afoot.
Mm-hmm.
So first question is, if Morphy takes this pawn, which he did not do, how does Black save his rook?
I see, maybe queen b4.
Queen before what?
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 You said queen before what?
I said queen b4.
Before what? Like queen before you leap?
Queen before.
Queen before what? Like you're putting the queen before the horse? What do you mean?
Yeah.
Oh. Queen before. Right, well, the queen was on b3 before it was on b7. Is that what you mean?
No.
Oh. Yeah, buzzer bait says queen before. Yeah, I don't know what she means either. Nobody gets it. They're all saying queen before. All right, but anyway.
Check.
What's that?
Check.
Check. Queen. Oh, queen to b4. I thought you meant before.
No.
Like the word before.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh. No, you didn't.
Right. Okay. So queen b4 check. Now.
Thank you, Dr. Chess RX. And I saw your nice comment earlier. I'm sorry I didn't acknowledge it. Hey.
Now, in this position, Morphy, to prevent queen before, played knight c3 after.
Okay.
And as I have said on many streams and videos and in my sleep and in my dreams, and when I woke up from surgery, you could play bishop takes f7 check.
Mm-hmm. What now?
Bishop takes f7 check.
You could play it, yeah.
Yeah, and the idea is if you take it, which would seem to refute that, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then you play queen takes b7, and Black doesn't have the move queen before check as he did before, because the queen's not on e7. So probably bishop takes f7 is an improvement. However, then this famous game wouldn't happen. So that's good he didn't play that. So he played knight c3. Okay. Now what excellent move did the count and the duke play? Now this isn't well known, and this is actually disputed. Okay, but I know for a fact it's true. Okay, we can discuss it if you want. A lot of people didn't know who the count and the duke were. It turns out it was the Count from Sesame Street and it was John Wayne. And that's why Black didn't play very well. That's true.
Hmm.
Yeah.
I have no idea what that even means.
What do you mean?
John Wayne?
Yeah, he's the Duke.
Oh.
What?
And I love John Wayne. I forgot that.
Terrible.
All right,
okay.
So
now this is the most excellent move, and this was recommended. It's so good. It's so excellent. It was recommended by Bill and Ted.
Hmm.
You know why?
Mm-mm.
Because it's excellent.
Mm.
Yeah. And after Bill and Ted recommended it, it was then recommended by, I can't think of his name, Austin Powers. Yeah. Okay. So it's an excellent move, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. No, it wasn't bogus. Okay, so how do you defend the B pawn? What's the best move which Black played in this position?
How do we defend the B pawn? I remember you could defend it by moving the C pawn.
That's correct.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, C6. That's excellent because you defend this.
Yeah, I remember. Then
now, when Karen was white in the last blitz game,
I remember the next move.
She had a pawn on c3 and she played c4, but the pawn on c3 was better defending the dark squares in your blitz game. Mm-hmm. And then here, c6 is better than c5 because it defends the white squares, right, which obviously white would had heretofore had access to. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, so what did white do in this position? He pinned the knight. So white has better development, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, probably ate a lot of corn or something. I don't know. Now, black made a further mistake. B5. Mm-hmm. Not completing his development, thinking white would retreat like a Frenchman. But Morphy was, even though he was from New Orleans, see, that's why they thought that. That he was, you know, like French Creole or something. Not French Canadian. Yeah. Okay, so what move, shocking, surprising move, did white play here, confusing his opponents?
This might be where he castles.
But might be.
Well, I'm, you asked me a move, I'm just saying, yeah, mm-hmm, he castles.
No.
Oh, no. Okay. Maybe he took. I can't remember.
You don't have to remember. You have to figure it out. You got to analyze for hours because you get paid by the hour. Mm-hmm. While Karen is analyzing, I will tickle.
Oh, maybe see? It's knight takes. Knight takes.
Stop. Help. She's hurting me.
I think it's maybe knight.
I'm delicate.
Knight takes B5. Hmm? Maybe?
Yes.
Okay. I did it.
Yeah.
I did it.
Okay. Then he took. Now, did he take with the queen? Or the bishop?
I don't remember.
You're not supposed to remember. You're supposed to play the best move. See, the reason I was tickling Karen, it had to do with the stream. It wasn't because I like tickling Karen. Ridiculous. We were talking about the Count from Sesame Street, mm-hmm, and I wanted to show you Tickle Me Elmo.
Not Tickle Me, come on.
Right. So which way?
I think the bishop.
Yeah, that's correct.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I don't like to be tickled.
Okay, now.
I'm in the stream.
Right, yeah, but there. I had to get a mani-pedi, and then my foot was getting tickled a lot. I didn't, mm-hmm, like that. Okay.
Yeah, I hate that too.
Right, and then for some reason the police were called when I kicked the, you know, the saw in the face by accident. Okay, now what did black do? Notice how black is in check.
Yeah, so I think they move the knight to block, but I don't.
Yeah, when I ask you questions about chess moves,
you're asking always, me to not try to remember, and I'm not going to do that.
No, no, that's not what I'm complaining about. Right. Often you don't say chess moves. Always say chess moves.
Oh,
don't say he moved the rook to the green square. Say the move like you're writing it down.
Okay. Let's see. Okay, knight bd7.
Now you're talking. Yeah. Now you're cooking with something. Yeah. All right. Now, according to Dmitry Komarov, who was watching the game live, what did he think about white's position?
I don't know.
He said, two bishops, what else?
Oh, he's the two bishops guy.
Okay. Two bishops, what else? Yeah. Okay. Now, what did Morphy play here? And then when I showed this game to Val Kilmer, what did he think about white's position?
I don't know. Let me try to think
he
of
said,
the move.
He said, I got two bishops, one for each of you.
All
right. Yay. Go tombstone.
What did he do? Maybe queen d6.
Queen d6? Whose turn is it?
Oh, yes, white.
Yeah. Yeah. This move was recommended by Sir Mix-a-Lot.
Get the rook involved, maybe.
Right? Yeah, Sir Mix-a-Lot likes this move.
How about rook d1?
Close. Does anybody get the Sir Mix-a-Lot?
I don't get it. Castles? I'm not sure.
You're not telling me which way.
Kingside castle.
Which one?
Oh, queenside would put the rook on that file, I guess.
Yeah, because that would be the way to mm-hmm. castle long, and it's strong, and it's time to get the pin on, right?
Okay.
It's long, castle, mm-hmm. and it's strong. Okay, right, because baby got back, right? No, but it's because it's long. Okay, so remember, as we say in Soviet Russia, Drinya Lakirovka. Harsho?
What?
Exactly. Okay, so now we're putting, you know, okay, now, Karen.
In this position,
how would he defend against, you know, the innumerable slings and arrows of outrageous fortune? And to take arms against the sea of troubles and by opposing end them, to die, to sleep no more, and say we end the heartache and thousand natural checkmates that flesh is heir to. Die, to sleep, perchance to dream. Aye, there's the rub, for in that sleep of checkmate, what opera game may come. 500 centidus from Pinky Jim. Man, I hated Pinky Jim until he did that.
You're so poetic.
Who, me? What?
I'm swooning.
That's the Hamlet gambit.
We love Pinky Jim.
Yeah, man, I was going to ban Pinky Jim, but then he gave 500 centidus.
Thank you, Pinky Jim. We love you.
Kangaroo says very good Russian, says the German.
And poet. What a poet you are.
Yeah, he says, I speak good Russian. Yeah. You actually know almost the whole soliloquy. Not only do I know it, then I, like, improve upon it. It's time to get the friction.
Ben has two or three works of literature that he can quote from.
Two or three? That's good. Harsh. What? Man, Karen's not impressed with my Longfellow. I don't know. Terrible. Yeah. You're originally from Ukraine? The Ukraine is weak, Kangaroo. Yeah. If you're from the Ukraine, how do you speak Russian? Bam. Gotcha. Okay. Right. Yeah. I used to be, you know why he likes the Ukraine so much? Because he's in Lviv with it. Oh, snap. Gotcha. What?
She didn't get her wasp.
Yeah. He's in Lviv. Yeah. Only Karen got that part.
It was too weird.
Yeah.
All right, keep going.
You know how old Kangaroo was when he moved from the Ukraine to Germany?
Who? How old was the Kangaroo?
Yeah.
Yeah,
Southern Chris got it. 9! Exactly. Okay. All right. Yeah, everybody got it. Okay. Now, okay, so how can black defend the knight on d7 from the slings and arrows?
Okay, I guess swing the rook on over.
Man, you did it again. I told you to say chess moves.
Rook d8.
There you go. Swing the rook over. All right, now, let's say that, unlike you, black is impressed with the Longfellow and castles. Watch. Bam! Also defending the knight and unpinning it.
That's right? Not what happened then.
I know, but I'm asking you. Okay, now, white has maiden 2, which you have to find.
Okay, if he had done that. All right, let's see. I think bishop, a6 check.
That's correct.
And then queen b7.
Right.
Right. Mm-hmm. So I did my square names and everything.
Yeah, I was thinking, like, man, when it was mate, Karen was, like, very accurate. Yeah. Okay, so rook d8 was played. Okay. All right. Now, okay. White has every piece involved except.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, that other rook over there is.
Right. So Morphy played here.
No, I think he was rook takes d7.
That's correct. And now, according to my stream rules, which Morphy knew, mm-hmm. why did he do that? What stream rule indicates he should do that?
Sack the exchange.
Always sack the exchange.
Right.
So what did black do in response?
I think rook takes.
Rook takes is correct.
Yeah, rook takes.
Okay.
D7.
And then what did George Thorogood recommend that white do here?
Move it on over.
Rook yeah.
D1.
Yeah, the big old rook is moving in. Okay, now black wants to trade queens as opposed to resign. Resigning was more accurate. Now, John MacArthur, who we met for 5 seconds outside the hotel in Atlanta when they had the Nationals here, mm-hmm. he's the guy I said hi to. I've known him since before you were born. And I used to teach chess with him in New York. And he showed this game to some kids while I was taking a nap, okay, because I was a good teacher. And he showed a variation to the kids that heretofore I'd never seen, right? Because the game went queen e6. Black wants to trade queens. Mm-hmm. He showed the kids queen b4, also with the idea of trading queens. Okay. Then you take the knight, because the knight was defending the rook. And if they take the queen, you play a very good Zwischenzug, right? Mm-hmm. What move would that be?
Bishop takes d7, check.
Check. Continue the sentence.
Oh, mate.
Mate. Yeah, that's a nice mate. I haven't seen a mate that good since last week's date night. That was a good mate. Okay, we looked at some really good chess games. All right, so he played queen e6, okay?
Yeah.
All right, then he played check. Which way did black take?
With...
No, I said zugzwang. Yeah.
With the knight?
With the knight, right. Mm. And now it's the most famous move ever that you remember.
I do remember it's queen b8 check.
Queen b8 check.
And then rook d8 mate. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I do remember that.
Yeah. That's the most famous move in Australia. Rook d8 mate.
Okay.
Yeah. Hooray. And you memorized that game until you forgot it.
A long time ago, I did.
Yeah. Yeah. I talked to... I talked to Tupac about this game. I did. Yeah. And I said, do you know when this game was played? And what did Tupac say? It was played a long time ago. Uh-huh. That's right. Exactly. The most famous constructed game ever. What? No, this was an actual game. Terrible.
What do you mean by constructed? Is that because there aren't accurate records of it?
No, he's just, you know.
That might be what he means.
No. A real long time ago. That's right. Yeah. All right. Thanks for watching. Oh, wait. Okay. Now we'll look at another game. Bam. Now what game am I going to show?
You didn't tell me.
Right. But you just figure it out.
Let's
see who gets it first. You were the chat.
Fischer Spassky.
No. Yep. Homomorphic 9 got it.
Where is it?
Von Bardeleben spelled with several mistakes. He put ban at the end. Like the guy's banned. Yeah.
Oh, well, let me see.
Who was white in that game? The Von Bardeleben game. What tournament was it at?
Well, Hastings.
What year?
1895.
Right.
Okay. I'm blanking out on the player for a moment.
He was the first world champion.
Pillsbury.
He was never the world champion.
Oh, yeah, he was never the
Pillsbury champion. Pillsbury won the tournament.
Steinitz.
Pillsbury won Hastings 1895.
Yeah, that's what
I was his prize for winning the tournament, Pillsbury? He took the cake.
Okay.
All right.
Hey, I got some of the facts right.
So now, do I have to fix this and put Steinitz von Bardeleben?
Hey, Chess with Abby, how's it going?
Okay, so
yeah, you definitely have to put
Steinitz. Okay. S-T-E-I-N-I-T-Z, correct, and then Von, V-O-N, yeah, and then B-A-R-D,
wait a minute,
Bardeleben, E-L-B-E-N, B-E-L-E-B-E-N, wait a minute, spell it so I can see what it looks like, yeah, type E-B-E-N, let me see how that looks, Von Bardeleben, that looks good. Man, I hope there's no Germans here watching telling me I spelled it wrong.
Is that correct?
I don't know. That's the way Kangaroo spelled it, so I guess so.
Okay.
He's German or Ukraine or something. Yeah.
All right.
Okay, that's good. Yeah. Now, as you all know, and by you all know, it's because you watch my streams a lot and my videos, this game was played in round 10 or 11. I forgot. I think 10. Before this game, Von Bardeleben had no losses.
Okay.
Then he lost. Then after this game, the tournament was really long, so there was more. He didn't have any wins. So he played like 9 or 10 games without losing, and like 14 games without winning. So that's psychologically crushing.
So he tilted.
Yeah. Yeah. Can you tell him he spelled it wrong anyway? No, no, boo, boo. Yeah. Yeah. Now, even though Von Bardeleben was upset at losing the game, like he left, he didn't resign, okay? He, you know, and he won what award?
Wait,
what award did Von Bardeleben win for not resigning and just leaving?
These Balls Award.
No, Kangaroo got it. The Nakamura Sportsmanship Award. That's right. Okay, now, Von Bardeleben might be upset that he lost and so forth, right? Mm-hmm. Nobody who ever lived, even his parents, would have heard of him if he didn't lose this game. Right? Mm-hmm. Nobody knows anything about Von Bardeleben except this game. So if this game wasn't played, I never would have heard of Von Bardeleben. You know? All right. Exactly. Mm-hmm. What? Okay. Right, even his parents. Now, if you watch a lot of Family Guy and memorize it, there's an episode where they do a flashback and Peter's on the bus. I think it's Peter. And there's this couple there. They're like in their 60s or 50s. And they're like, our son's... Oh, no, it wasn't Peter. It was like a random person. He's like, our son's a famous person. Who's our son? And they have a long discussion about it. And they're like, he was in this movie... He might have been in this movie, and the guy in the bus tells them who's their son. Is like, yeah, that's our son. Yeah. Do you guys remember who that was?
I don't think
so. No, do they remember?
Cut off a little bit.
No, do they remember who it was? That was funny.
Maybe we're just too... We need to zoom it out a little. We're in.
Come on. Who knows? Anybody? Anyway, the correct answer is Ron Livingston. Is your son Ron Livingston? That's it. That's who our son is. Was that Futurama? No, it's Family Guy. Yeah, I like that. Who's our son? I don't know. Okay, that was like this. Who's our son? Even though their name was Von Bardeleben, they didn't know their son's name was Von Bardeleben. Mm-hmm. It's weird. Okay.
Is that what reminded you of that?
Yes. Okay. Also, if it was Futurama, Kangaroo would be all over that, like Oprah on self-promotion. Okay. So, I got to change that to Nakamura from Oprah. I don't know. Who self-promotes more, Naka or Oprah? Discuss. Vote in the chat. Anybody?
Yeah, I don't know, but...
That's a tough one. Yeah. Well, they should have known his last name. Yeah. Mm-hmm. The flex tape guy. What? Oprah, no doubt. Unanimous Naka. They always do that in my chat, even though it's your chat. Mm-hmm. Somebody says it's obviously this, somebody says obviously the other one. Okay, Buchanan is the right answer. That's right. Okay, now, this is Steinitz von Bardeleben. Karen also memorized this game.
But I have to say, mm-hmm. This was 5 years ago. I do not even remember anything about the game. Mm-hmm. And I never was real firm with my memory on this one like mm-hmm. I was with
Opera. Okay, now, when kids play in scholastic tournaments, mm-hmm. they always castle or play knight c3. And then they play them both. And then, because of that, Steve Davis quit chess. Okay. Right. And Steve Davis is famous for what sport?
I mean, I have no chance at all.
Snooker.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, see, look at the chat.
Oh.
Yeah. He was the best player in the world when I lived in Europe. And now there's been, like, one or two guys who were better. Some people think...
Hey, Mimi, yo.
What's that guy's name? That's Stephen Hendry. Who's the other guy? Who's the guy everybody says is good now? I forgot his name. Yeah, Sullivan. Ronnie O'Sullivan. Mm. Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, Doric.
I think everybody agrees Ronnie O'Sullivan is better than Steve Davis, like in historically. But when I lived in Europe, Ronnie O'Sullivan didn't exist. So it was Steve Davis. Mm. Now, I'd tell you a funny story. Ephraim Reyes is the best in snooker? No, not in snooker, he's not. Okay, anyway, so I was watching snooker, and then Jimmy White was playing. He's like an exciting player, right? He can beat anybody, but mm-hmm. he can lose to anybody. Okay, now in snooker, the balls are smaller and the pockets are smaller. On a pool table, if you hit the ball near the hole, it'll go in. It'll hit, you know, it'll, you don't have to hit it exactly in. It'll, you know, you can, you know what I mean. In snooker.
I do play pool.
Right. But in snooker, you got to hit the ball in. If it hits anything, it's not going in. Mm. Okay. So here's what happened. Okay. This is the snooker table. Okay. Snooker table is much bigger than a pool table. Much bigger. Mm-hmm. Okay. So Jimmy White had the ball here, and the other ball was here, And he hit it and it went here and here, which is impossible. Now, in regular pool, that's pretty easy for a pro. Mm-hmm. In snooker, it's impossible. You can't make that shot. Anyway, so they went to a commercial break and they came back, and the two announcers, one's an announcer and one's a pool player, right? A snooker player. Mm-hmm. So the snooker player set up the shot. He said, I'm going to try that shot because that shot's really hard. And he said, and I want to tell you guys in the audience, we didn't shoot this 50 times and then we did the one where I made it. This is the only time I'm doing it. Okay?
Okay.
He shot it. He missed it so bad, he would never make it, ever. Like, when he hit it and he missed it, he went, wow, that was harder than I thought. Like, he was like me. Like, he had no hope of ever making it. It was ridiculous. Yeah.
Wow, that's
hard. Anyway, don't forget that.
Hey, Storm.
Yeah.
Hey, PDX.
My favorite scene in snooker, and this is from, like, 33 years ago, like, it's, I think it's 147 or 148, I forgot. This guy says 140, oh, because the perfect was, okay. Yeah, it's either 147 or 148, I forgot. But anyway, it's probably 147 based on the 146. Mm. That's the highest score you can get. My favorite 147 is when the guy did it. He got the perfect game. And then he jumped into his opponent's arms. His opponent caught him and they hugged.
Aw. That's so sweet.
If you guys know from that 33 years ago, that was funny. Yeah. Okay. Because he did it on TV and it was really difficult and so forth. 146 is harder. That's true. Okay. Also, it's more difficult. Okay. So C3... Why did white play C3? What's the next move going to be?
B4.
Close.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, yeah, D4.
D4. If you want to play B4, you can play it now. Mm-hmm. And what would that be called? What's the name of this variation?
Maybe the Evans?
Mm-hmm.
Evans Gambit?
Named after?
Captain Evans.
Correct. He was a ship captain. Yeah, not Larry Evans. Boo. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Also, there was an IM named Larry D. Evans.
Mm.
It's not even a joke. Okay, so C3, knight F6. Now we have one of the Feingold rules. Okay? Mm-hmm. Feingold rule is if the king is here, you do one thing, and if white has castled, you do another thing. So one thing is to take, and one thing is to go here.
Okay.
So we see where the king is, and you decide based on that. With the king on e1, you take this pawn, because when they take back, you can play bishop b4 check. If the king's castled, you can't play bishop b4 check, so you just go here.
Okay.
So he has a castled, so he took. Now, what's funny about this is you can play knight c3 or bishop d2. This variation is not played very much at the top level. The last game I remember was like Ifan Aronian from Vikanze like 5 years ago. Mm-hmm. Okay. And so knight c3 is a pawn sack that was played 1 billion times 100 years ago. Then they play bishop d2, and they sort of gave up. After knight c3, black should take this pawn, but he played the move d5. What's funny is, on my stream about 2 weeks ago, I had this position. Okay, and then they went takes, takes, castles. And here... Von Bardeleben played bishop e6. I don't think my opponent did that. Okay, bishop g5 attacking the queen. Bishop e7. So pawn structure-wise, black is doing well. Black has a solid pawn structure. Black has all of his pieces developed. However, white's castled and black hasn't castled. And some positions in chess, especially at the top level, they have their advantages for each side, and the way to evaluate the position is to see what's likely to happen over the next few moves. So if over the next few moves nothing happens, then black is fine, because black's fine. But since black hasn't castled yet, if white can somehow keep the black king in the center, then he won't be fine, okay? And if he castles very soon, what would the indigo girl say about his position?
I don't know any of their music.
He'd be closer to fine.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Also, Dr. Fine, Dr. Howard, Dr. Fine. Okay. So he played the excellent bishop takes d5, recommended by Bill and Ted. Bishop takes, knight takes, queen takes, bishop takes, knight takes. And black wants to castle now, so white plays rook e1. Okay, now if it was white's turn to move, mm-hmm. white would play rook e5, and then he would play the Steinitz gun, queen e2, rook e1, tripling up on the bubble up. Okay, mm-hmm. what move did black play preventing that? How do you stop rook
f6? E5?
That's right, he played f6. Okay, and then Steinitz played queen e2, threatening mate, and then queen d7. Okay, so far, white's playing better than perfect. In fact, perfection is crap compared to the way he's playing. That's okay. And now Steinitz made a mistake, and then von Bardeleben made a mistake. Okay, what white should do is white should play either rook ad1 or d5. But he played rook ac1. This gives black a respite, which he didn't take. He needs to play king f7, breaking the pin. Okay, mm-hmm. and then play knight d5, rook e8, and then order Papa John's. Okay, and it would take, I don't know, 120 years to show up, but you know, that's actually quicker than usual. So can't really argue. Okay. So instead of that, after king f7, the important variation is if you play queen check, forking the king and the c pawn, then there's knight d5. Okay. And what would Michael Douglas say? Defense. Okay. You didn't see Falling Down, right?
No.
Okay, great movie.
Oh, I'd like to see it.
Yeah, Robert Duvall, Tuesday Weld, etc.
Hey, Boris. How's it going?
Okay, so instead, he played c6, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, and now the Steinitz played a famous move. Okay, and it was, and because of this move, they made the movie Airplane, just so they could make the joke, what's your clearance, Clarence? And then the response was, what's your vector, Victor? Mm-hmm. Right? Who was the co-pilot in Airplane?
Was it Kareem Abdul-Jabbar?
Now you're talking.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I saw that.
I am joking, but don't say Shirley. Yeah. Should I ban this guy from your stream?
What's he saying?
This guy.
No. Let me do him. But that's not even the right mouse.
Oh. Roger, Roger. What's your vector, Victor?
Negative.
One message was deleted by moderator. So it's gone.
Banned. That's fine.
And he's banned.
You can, you know, if you want to.
But I like Robert De Niro.
At De Niro, you can send me a note, kiss my ass, tell me you're sorry, and I'll let you back on.
Bam.
That's the process to get back on my channel. I don't do like Hikaru and just don't let people in. Like, I'm banned over there. I will definitely let you back in, but you're going to have to say you're sorry. That's okay. It.
Now, so what move did white play?
Let's see. I gotta look. Don't tell me.
I can't even see your username, Boris.
Let's see if you go there. I don't know. Maybe 95. I don't really see a move. I don't know what the move is.
It's a clearance sacrifice.
Well, that was my guess. 95.
Okay, that's just a regular sacrifice.
All right.
That just sacks the knight.
Maybe d5.
D5. That clearing the d4 square for the knight.
Yeah.
You can't take with the queen because queen takes knight mate.
Oh, yeah.
And you can't take with the knight because chess.com has a bug. So you have to take with the pawn, right?
Right.
And now we have knight d4. And now we're threatening one of my favorite emotes.
Knife f5.
Yeah, that wins immediately. Or as Yasser would say, immediately. Okay, so von Bardeleben played king f7, stopping knight f5. Knight e6, threatening rook c7. Rook hc8. Queen g4, threatening queen g7, queen f8 mate. G6, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now he always retreated. Knight G5 check, attacking the queen and the king. You agree?
Yeah.
What did Black do about that? How did he save his queen?
Let's see, I guess King E8.
Right. And now the most famous sequence in all of chess history.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I'm not going to know it.
If he was on my stream, what would he always do?
If who was on your stream?
Anybody. Always.
Oh, so, well, I saw the cheat. Mm-hmm. I saw the sack in the chat.
Yeah, so rook takes e7. Now let's analyze.
All right.
Shall we?
Sure.
King d8, mate. That was good analysis.
That's quick.
Yeah, that was quick. Okay. If queen takes, now the rook isn't defended sufficiently. So white's up a piece.
Yay.
Okay, so there's two other moves to look at. The move that was played and the move that wasn't played. The move that was played was king f8. Let's take with the king, shan't we? That's the move we didn't look at.
Shall we, yes.
Okay. Rook e1 check. Your king has to defend your queen. Okay, you can go to d8 or d6. They both lose.
Mm-hmm.
If you go to d8, I play knight here check. And now if you go to the e-file, you can't go to this e-file because it's illegal. Then I do this discovered check, winning your queen. So you have to play king d6. And now I have more than one way to win. Queen b4 check. If king here, rook c1 is mate. So king c7, rook c1 check, queen f4 check, and knight e6. And there's actually many ways to win, but that's one of them. That's the one I like. There's other ways to win. Okay, so if I'm Bardeleben, play king f8, confusing the audience. Okay, now the reason black can get away with king f8 is white has a back rank issue. So you can never take the queen on d7 because you're going to get mated on the back rank.
Oh, yeah.
So Steinitz played rook f7 check. If king e8, queen takes queen mate. If queen takes rook, we once again play rook c8 and queen c8. So he played king g8. Then he did it again. If king f8, knight takes h7 check, the king has to go here or here, and then I take the queen with check. So you can't play king f8. You can't play king takes rook because queen takes queen is check. You can't play queen takes rook because of rook takes rook check. So you play king h8. King g8 here, and then he left. Now he resigned.
Mm.
Okay. Now after king h8, we had a similar position 2 moves ago, sorry, except there was a black pawn here. And then he took the pawn and went back to g7. So now that there's no pawn there, we can play queen h4 check. Okay, and black only has one legal move in these positions. Okay, if king here, then queen takes his mate. Next move. King here. King here. King here. This is the only legal move. And then mate. So after rook g7 check, after the second rook g7 check, he resigned because of that variation.
Yeah, that's a great game. I just couldn't remember it all.
Yeah. I couldn't remember it either, but I was like guessing some of the moves, and then I got lucky. Yeah, and the analysis. That was fortuitous. That means lucky. What movie?
Tombstone.
Correct. Very good. Right.
He very rage good. Quit. Yeah, that was the first documented rage quit.
That's correct. Yeah. Tombstone. That's
cool. Yeah. So what are people doing?
We have 156 viewers. That's more than Akaru. Oh, wait a minute. No, it's not. That was close. It's more than the channels that are offline. Well, some of them. Yeah.
Is it time for Fine Gold Gelfman?
But chess with Ovi, Karen already played the viewers today, and she's going to play them again.
True. I am going to play them again if time
she will play again.
Permits, which it may not.
Yeah, it'll permit. Yeah.
Well, I don't want to rush the games because I'm enjoying the games.
No, I understand. We'll just look at one more game.
No, we said top five. I said top.
Well, then we can't do top five. Then we have a reservation for dinner.
That's not till 7, right?
Right. Hmm. Yeah. Yeah, my throat hurts and COVID.
Oh, your throat's hurting?
Oh, yeah.
I hope we don't have COVID. Oh, yeah. I don't think we do, though. Yeah. Oh, you're going to sleep? Good night, Zerk.
Hmm.
Yes, I love
to. Bon nuitus. Mwah!
I love to play you, Ovi. Okay, I hope it'll work out. Go ahead and get your challenge in the queue. That's a hit.
Yeah, we're in Georgia. Nothing's closed. Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to have Thai food. Ovi, have you eaten at this restaurant, Ovi? What's it called?
Nam Thai.
Nam Thai. Nam Thai.
N-A-H-M.
Yes, good.
Yeah, as in nom, 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 nom.
Yeah. Right? Well, in Ovi's neck of the woods, you know, maybe Surin. There might be a Surin over that way.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I like Nam Thai. I think I like Surin slightly better, though. Hmm. Anyway, so you want to go ahead and with the next game?
Oh, yeah.
All right, so we're going to do another game. Ben's going to tell us another game we need to know about.
But I don't know any other games. Okay, here's my game with Gelfand. Let's look at... Can they see that?
And I didn't see what you sent, Ovi, but...
Can you type in Kasparov Topalov?
Make sure it's 3 or 5 minute unrated, no increment.
Kasparov. Space Topalov.
Let's see.
Topalov.
Wait.
Topalov.
Okay, there we go.
Yeah, close enough.
Hold on. It's top. Yeah, there it is.
Close enough.
Okay.
Here it is. This is Karen's favorite game. Right, sweetie?
This one, I don't think I've seen it. I don't recall.
Many years ago, a guy in Vegas gave me $100 to explain the game to him.
Really?
Yeah. He gave me the $100 and I ran like I could never, like the fastest I ever ran.
This game is otherworldly homomorphic? Well,
this game is all right.
What do you mean? It's supposed to be the top five.
Right. Well, a lot of people think this is the greatest game ever played.
Oh, well, good.
Yeah.
I'm excited to see.
Yeah, we already that happened yesterday. Yeah. November, December in Dubai. We could go to that. Dubai's nice.
Wait, what's going on?
The World Championship, assuming, you know, the candidates has ever played.
Oh yeah, let's definitely go.
Yeah, but what about you have kids? Actually, you won't have one kid.
That's true. One kid will be in college. Yeah. Maybe we
should
can...
we tell them what happened with that kid today?
Yeah, you can tell. Yeah.
You could tell him it's your kid.
Well, I haven't even talked to him yet. My son, my oldest son, Holden, is very, very bright, made great scores on his SATs, but he didn't get his abs in, you know, in the early decision for, I don't think, most of the colleges.
You're losing the audience here.
No, let me tell the story my way.
All right.
And that's the background. So anyway, he did go ahead and apply to MIT regular decision, which means he has almost no chance. So they don't hand those decisions out till mid-March. But he did find out today that he at least made it to the interview phase. They like him enough that they want to interview him, which I don't know what's not to like. He made a 36 on the ACT.
Yeah, the problem is it wasn't an interview to get him into the school. It was to watch the movie Interview with a Vampire. That was the problem.
Anyway, we were excited he at least gets an interview.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it. Okay, onward.
Okay, so there was a grandmaster who was talking about this game recently. I think it was Laco.
Mm-hmm.
But I could be wrong. He said, man, I couldn't wait for Kasparov Topalov. They were going to play a Sicilian, and it was going to be really sharp, and it was going to be the greatest thing ever. And then Topalov played d6, and I was so distraught. But then it turned out it was the greatest game ever, so it was okay. Yeah. Okay. So they played a very unusual variation of the Pirtz, which is nobody ever plays with either side. It just got weird right away. And nobody castled kingside. Very suspicious. Everybody's castling queenside. Always play king b1. That's why Kasparov won. And then they both castle queenside. Very rare at the top level, both players castle queenside. Okay. Now, this idea of knight c1 to b3, we often see in a same-ish King's Indian, which this looks like. Obviously, the pawn's on c2 instead of c4, because we're trying to get our bishop on f1 developed. And if the knight's on g2, it's hard to get our bishop out. Mm-hmm. And in some same-ishes, you play knight here, bishop out, and put the knight back on e2. And even though they're all different, some low-rated players, it's all the same-ish to them. Yeah.
Hey, Kangaroo already typed it before he said it.
You okay? What? Yeah. What are you saying?
He knew what you were going to say.
Hmm? What do you mean?
He typed go same-ish before you said it.
Right, that's the name of the opening.
I know.
But that wasn't the joke. That's...
But you always say same-ish, like same.
Right, but he doesn't know that.
He does.
Okay, he does. Plays the same-ish, he said.
Oh, okay.
That's because he's German. What was Samish's first name?
Oh, God, I have no...
I'll give you a hint, he's German.
German? Yeah. Adolf.
Close enough. Yeah, Friedrich. I called him Fritz. And the guy said Adolf. Yeah, Friedrich, yeah. I just called him Fritz because we were like, that son? Yeah. You would eat a Samish? Yeah. Okay. This other guy is going crazy over here.
Hey, the lonely Joey.
All right. So, takes, rook takes, c5, retreat, queen b6. Okay. And we get this famous position. Check. Here, rook he1, d4. Okay. And... This is the famous thing here. So this position, White's not winning, but you know, Kasparov played a very exciting move, and Topalov decided to be combative after that move. He played the move rook takes d4, and the idea is if Black plays queen takes queen, White can take with the rook. Mm-hmm. So then White would be a pawn up, and he's got pressure on the f file. Now, of course, in this exact position, White doesn't necessarily have a big threat, so Black can make a defensive move, and then White would be a pawn ahead, but this pawn's pretty weak on d5. Mm-hmm. So it might have been safer to not take the rook and play some move like king b6 attacking the knight, something like that. But okay, he took up the gauntlet. He took the rook. Okay, and rook e7 check, sacking another rook. He had two rooks, one for each of them. Now, obviously, if you take with the queen, right? I take this with check. You have to play king b8 because it's got to do something. And you can't go here because there's a bishop really far away. So you go here, knight c6 check, and mate. So he didn't take the rook because he didn't want to get mated. Okay. So he played king to... b6. You could also play king to b8, but I have to remember why that's bad. And you should feel bad. Oh, if you play king b8, okay, I play queen takes d4, threatening queen a7 mate. And if you take my rook, that transposes to the line we just looked at, queen b6 check and mate. Okay, so you play king b6. Queen takes d4, king takes a5. So White's down a rook and a knight, but he has a passed pawn. Not passed pawn, I'm just kidding about. Okay, so moving on up. King there. Yeah. So if Black gets mated, he loses. But if he doesn't get mated, he's up a rook and a knight. Now we have to stop for station identification. You guys at home, you like this game because Kasparov sacrificed a lot of pieces and he won, and Topalov walked his king up the board. That has a lot going for it as far as excitement for the spectators. However, at this level where the players are quite good, they don't sacrifice and just hope that it works. So Kasparov saw dozens of variations, calculated many moves ahead, and in those variations, he was winning. And he didn't see a defense for black if black accepted the material. Okay, and he'd have to look really far ahead to make sure. Kasparov can't be sacrificing pieces, it doesn't work, and then resign down like three pieces. That's embarrassing. Mm-hmm. Okay, and you wouldn't do that if you were a top player. You wouldn't say like, oh, I missed all the defense, I resign. Like that's, you know, that's like what I do. Okay, so somebody said, what's wrong with queen b2? Very similar move was played. Queen c3, threatening queen b3 mate. Mm-hmm. Okay, queen c3 is better because we play king b2 later. Okay, queen takes d5 is forced, stopping the mate. Okay, now, if you take with the bishop to stop the mate, right? And I go king b2, I'm threatening queen b3. This would be a funny position if he took the rook, just for, you know,
yeah.
The fact that white has no pieces left and he wins. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, now the difference between taking with the bishop and the queen is when he took with the queen, which is what he did do. Now if you play king b2 with the same idea, queen d4 pins the queen. So black wins. Mm. Okay. Which if the bishop was on d5, you couldn't do that. All right. So he played rook a7, threatening rook takes a6 checkmate, which you have to stop. Now, if you play rook d6 to stop the checkmate, then the heretofore defense offered by me on king b2, which is queen d4, doesn't work because the rook on d6 is overworked. So for example, rook d6, king b2 threatening this mate, queen d4, this rook is defending both. So white can win by taking either the pawn or the queen. Obviously you would take the queen because if he takes your queen, it's mate in one, rook takes a6 mate. So you can't play rook d6, so Topalov didn't play rook d6. So Topalov played bishop b7, defending the mate. And Kasparov took the bishop. You can't take the rook because queen b3 is mate. Okay, you can't move the queen like to d4 something because queen b3 is mate. So he played queen c4. Obviously, if black trades queens, he's winning because he's up a lot of material. Okay, queen takes f6. And white has almost all of his material back. And white's threatening queen takes a6 mate. The defense to queen takes a6 mate is very funny. How would you defend with black in this position? Recommended by Nigel Short. Hint.
Let's see.
Recommended by George and Wheezy.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like you're making a move it on up reference.
Move it on up. King takes a3.
Oh, I was...
Now queen takes isn't mate because the king takes b4. And now if it's black's move, rook d1 mate, I mate you, you mate me, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. So he did play queen takes a6 check, king takes b4. Now black is up the exchange. And black's threatening rook d1 check winning. And white has no good checks of any kind. And white's bishop on h3 is shallow and pedantic. It looks like black's winning. But Kasparov, he really PO'd Topalov by playing.
I guess c3.
C3, yeah.
But I wouldn't.
Yeah, check. You can't take with the queen because the queen's defending the b5 pawn.
Okay.
So you get crushed. So he took with the king. Queen a1 check. God damn. Okay, you have to play king to d2. If you play king d3, right, what should white always play in that position?
Bishop f1.
Always play bishop f1. Right. Okay, so you play king d2.
Hey, Indo Queen, how's it going?
You got it?
Okay. I got it.
Queen b2 check. Now, do you go to d1 or e1? If you go to e1, then I got rook e7 check. God damn. So that's not good. So So he went to d1. Okay. Now there's no good check for white. Okay. Mm-hmm. But Kasparov knows to always play.
Bishop f1.
Yeah. Attacks the queen. If the queen moves away randomly, right, then queen e2 is mate.
If he does what? I'm sorry.
If the queen moves randomly somewhere, queen e2 mate. Queen here mate.
Oh.
If you take the bishop, which he did not do, queen c2, rook e7, Papa John's.
Oh, you so, like to see Ben on the stream, Mendo?
Okay, so he played rook to d2. And now, what was the worst 80s, 90s hip hop children's duo?
When now?
What?
80s, 90s?
Yeah.
Children's hip hop
duo.
Children's hip hop duo.
Correct. You spelled the name wrong, but that's right.
Oh, yeah. I wasn't going to get
Crisscross.
That. I wasn't going to get
right?
That.
So watch this cross pin. Are you confused yet?
No, I'm listening.
Now, this rook is attacking this queen, and this bishop is attacking this queen. Mm-hmm. So white played rook to d7. Threatening queen takes rook mate and threatening bishop takes queen. Black can't play rook takes queen because it's illegal.
Because
it's pinned.
Oh, okay, yeah.
And also white's threatening mate and the queen. So rook d7 is great.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay, so he took the rook. And he takes the queen. And now white's threatening queen e2 checkmate. And queen c1 checkmate. So you have to take the bishop. And then he takes the rook and whites up material. Queen for a rook. Rook to d3. He defends his pawn. c3. He stops the pawn. f4, saving his pawn. King c1. Queen a7, threatening queen g1 check. You can't take the pawn on h2 because queen g1 check wins the rook. And then the h-pawn's attacked. If I take the h-pawn, I defend my h-pawn. And then your pawns fall like dominoes, like a house of cards. Checkmate. Futurama.
Wait, you said you can't take the pawn on h2?
Right, because queen g1 check wins the rook.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And if you don't take the pawn, I'm going to go here, taking this, defending this, and then it's the wrap it up button. Mm-hmm. And so here Topalov resigned. A lot of people think that's the greatest game ever.
The fox in the hen house, or whatever it's called. Fox in the hen house. Mm. Are you going to show Anand Aronian or Rubinstein Rotelli?
It's Rotwelly.
Oh, Rotwelly?
Yeah, and he reversed all the names. It's Aronian Anand, it's Rotwelly Rubinstein. Mm-hmm. Terrible.
Probably typing his phone.
Huh?
Well, I don't know, because Ben says his voice is tired, so we may have to
and
only
also,
do,
you know, you got to play some chess.
We may only have to do three, so the title of my stream might be a misnomer. But maybe we can continue this the next time you stream with me. We'll
That's correct.
The next ones that you were going to do.
Yeah. Ovi said he can't play you. He's busy.
Well, let me see who's in the queue. Okay, so we're going to, we just did top three.
Ooh,
not
191 viewers with no raids or nothing.
Yay, not top five as advertised.
Ha, gotcha, bitches.
But, you know, we'll do some more next time.
Mm-hmm.
So, because Ben, I think his throat's been hurting. I hope we don't have the COVID.
Why not?
You know, but it seems like we'd feel worse than this.
Yeah. What? Oh.
So I don't think we have it.
And there's only one cure for COVID, Thai food.
Right. Our next sub battle. Ben is in. Well, I don't know. Ben has never done a sub battle.
Hey, you broke 200 viewers.
Or you did do a sub battle with, who didn't show up?
The chess bras.
Oh, yeah.
I prefer Karen's chess bra anyway.
You demand a refund?
Look at you getting over 200 viewers. You're the best.
Well, you're, we've got
in this
your
position,
ballot,
Black
the
resigned.
Plus the rest of you.
So. Yeah, here Black went belly up.
All right, well, let me play some people. Let me see if Ovi's over here. Let me close this. It does appear that Ovi is here.
Chess without Ovi? Oh, with Ovi.
Ready to give me the beat down with his 1900 rating.
Yeah, Ovi's not as bad as he plays. Mm-hmm.
Hey, Ovi, we missed you at the club. You need to come back. We went to karaoke the other night, and Deepak and this other chess player were going to go, but then they got lost, so they didn't go. He texted me, and I didn't see it. I don't know about you guys, but I get texted on 10 different apps, and I just can't always see. If it's not on my phone, if it's on WhatsApp or Messenger or any of these other ones, I'll see it eventually. karaoke. Hey, we were there last night. There are videos. Spencer went last night. Ben even showed up. So, briefly. The loser of the sub battle has to sing. I guess I could.
Yeah, Karen got mad at me last night. I was looking at pictures of women on my favorite site. You know what site that is?
Women on your favorite site. I don't know.
Only eFans.
What?
Oh. Talked about this yesterday.
Come on. Yeah, the Kangaroo. That's right. I remember now. You were not asymptomatic. You tested positive for antibodies twice.
I ain't got no antibodies.
I tested for the antibodies because I thought surely to God I'd had it and just didn't know it. Mm-hmm. But I didn't have the antibodies. Mm-hmm. I didn't switch to Signal. All my data is being stolen. You know, I don't want my data stolen, but I don't obsess over it. I just got other things in life to worry about than my data. Come on. As long as no naked pictures make it out into the, you know, internet, it's fine. They'll steal my credit card. Let me see. It seems like I should have done something different. I'm gonna get an isolated pawn, maybe. All right. No, so I didn't really like that.
Money can't buy me love, but I can skip the queue.
Pro hey. Bodies.
Yeah, data was good on Night Court. Go Brent Spiner.
Now, that's not to say I don't worry about my data and care. I do care about my data. It's just, you know, I got a lot of stuff I worry about. That is so low on my things to worry about, you know, because, you know, it seems to
Do you worry about Captain Picard?
Where do you live? I live in Atlanta, Georgia.
No, where do you live?
Area. Mm-hmm. That's what I said. I read it correctly.
I know.
All right. The hillbilly couple. Spiner.
Yep.
Who's that? I didn't
know. Brent Spiner, he played Data. Mm. Yep, the hillbilly couple, that's correct. Can you beat the Kobayashi Maru? Of course I can. I cheat. Bam.
Yeah, I agree. The messaging apps. No, I don't think they should be abolished or horrible. I'm just saying this is why I miss text sometimes. And actually, Kangaroo texted me one time on WhatsApp. There could even be one right now from Kangaroo, and I didn't see it.
Kangaroo?
For a day or two. So I do use it for that. I'm just slow.
Yeah, the last time you missed Kangaroo's text, he was hopping mad.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, I felt bad that karaoke was missed.
No, it was Captain Kangaroo. Now it's Admiral Kangaroo.
Bishop can't be happy.
Don't worry. Be happy. That's probably one of Kangaroo's favorite episodes. Don't worry, be happy. That is a great episode. Mm-hmm. Be happy. Yeah, I think Zoidberg has the line in that song. Not the best singer, not the worst. Be happy. But does Zoidberg worry? Favorite Simpsons episode? I don't know. There's too many good ones. I can't stay mad at you so much. The Taw subscribed. Hooray.
Yay.
I fought the Taw and the Taw won.
Hey, the Taw. Please don't hate me because I haven't emailed you back about the emotes.
Is that Mikhail Taw?
I'm the worst. I know I'm the worst.
Mikhail Taw the Claw?
Definitely the worst. But.
Are you Frederick Yates? Are you divorced?
Yeah, that's just the way it is right now.
Some things will never change. I don't believe it.
I'm the worst. I have so many emails I need to email.
That's right, Kangaroo.
And I detest emails. But it's a fact of life.
No, hey, your opponent has Connect 4. Exciting.
Now let me try to focus for a moment here. Ovi's tough.
He is. Oh, yeah.
He's tough.
He's the best player in his chair.
Tough for somebody like me. Oh, shit. I didn't want to do that. Darn it.
Such language.
I didn't want to trade.
Be happy. Libro Q subscribed. Hooray. Lots of Star Trek Next Generation characters. Q.
He was just waiting on me to do that too.
The waiting is the hardest part.
He knew I was going to do it. I mean, he knew it. He understood. I'm a lower.
The waiting is the
totally
hardest
got it.
Part.
Now, come on.
Take it to the heart.
He knew exactly what was up.
The waiting is the hardest.
The world of the lower.
If only you started pre-moving earlier.
Yeah.
That was close. Network error. Please try again.
Let me try to refresh this. No. GGOV. I hate everybody when I lose like that. Except for you. Yeah. I could never hate Ovi, but man, I feel like a momentary rage. Then I'm not mad.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, do you want to... take a peek at it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I have to slightly.
Yeah, I know. I was trying to beat you on time. I feel like I'm better than my rating. But I guarantee that every one of you guys think the same thing about your rating.
Yeah, here you could just take that. And then
yeah.
Probably better for you. Because if he takes back, you can move his king or something.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't see that.
Yeah, here I would take on d4. Hey, you have a train. Baron Salad gifted 5-7.
Yay. Hey, I haven't seen you, Baron Salad. I've gotten no subs. No gifted subs today, I don't think. But yay.
This is okay.
Thank you, Baron Salad. Always generous.
Yeah, I wouldn't play knight b3, but it's okay. His knight's really good on e4.
Okay.
Knight on b3 is not as
good. Trade it out.
Okay. What we played was all right. Okay. This is fine. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Now here, in this position, you shouldn't, like, do stuff. Now, when you do take on e4, which I wouldn't do, but it's not that bad, the pawn's pinned because it's pinned to his rook on e8.
Mm-hmm.
So I wouldn't take this because your bishop's a good bishop. But if you do take it, now you want to try to win this pawn. So you could try to play, like, knight c5 or knight d2. Or you could play d5 attacking his knight. Yeah, so this probably loses a pawn, but you have compensation. Yeah, and here, I wouldn't play queen e1. Your queen's not great on e1. But okay, it's not bad. And then, yeah, you play queen c3, but you didn't mean to trade queens. Yeah, your rook's good on c7.
Yeah, I didn't mean to play that. I was just low on, we're both low on time.
Yeah, even this is okay.
Yeah, I was going to try to,
and then, yeah, here I would play rook c7, and I would always play knight a5. Like here, you play knight a5, and you put pressure here, and then you have, like, rook d6, and you just keep attacking these two things. Okay.
Yeah, I knew I was going to get skewered somehow later, that dumb bishop, because I kept... trying to remember that.
You can play knight takes a6 here, because if he takes it, his bishop's attacked. Still probably not good because of e3. e3's sort of annoying.
Yeah, I don't believe in dirty flags.
Yeah, and then rook e2. It might just be that you're losing here, because you need to play rook e2, but you can't.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, so probably after e3, you're in a lot of trouble. Yeah, rook c4 is not a good move. Here you have to try to defend against, e3, e2, e1. But again, you don't have any time on your clock.
Yeah.
Here probably rook e2 is okay. Like, just to stop him from playing e3.
Okay.
And then, yeah, here you did well to... Yeah, he shouldn't play rook takes e2. And then he shouldn't give up his e-pawn. Well, yeah. I'm still winning because your a-pawn's weak. And then, yeah, you just got to start pre-moving earlier.
Yeah.
Yeah, you care too much about the position when you have less than 20 seconds.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. I know that's an issue for me.
But, yeah, I mean, I never seen Ovi win a game, so that was interesting for me. Level 3, what happened?
Thank you, Ovi. Yeah. No, Ovi always gives me the beat down.
You always go up and see what happened.
What? Oh,
you can see if anybody donated or subbed. Level 3.
Well, Byron Salad gave a bunch of gifts.
Right.
There might
be
some.
Go.
Oh,
Libro.
Q. Yeah. Libro Q. I'm sorry that we didn't see that.
He gave my favorite number.
999 cent to dues.
Yeah.
Let's see what else we missed. And there's another noise. Thank you, Pinky Jim, for those 300 bits. Let's scroll it up, scroll it up, scroll it up.
Mm-hmm.
Because I was focused on playing and wanting to listen.
Yeah.
I think
that's okay. Okay. Yeah. Yay. And then what Pinky Jim just do?
I just thanked him for those sentences.
Yeah. Go Pinky Jim, but don't go. Yeah. All right, we're at 95. There is Bauer and Sal again. What? 5 more subs. Now we're at level 5.
Yay. You're thank always you, at level 5.
Good job.
Yeah. Yay. Pinky Jim avoiding the ban again.
Hooray.
Hey, Chris, 3795.
Let's get to level 6. Not sure how.
Yeah. Gift subs. It's raining. It's raining men.
Hallelujah. That's Homer's favorite song in the jukebox.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, and they took it out because he gave him the sugar me do.
Mm-hmm.
And then he threw it out the window, and it landed on Smithers, who was driving. He goes, ooh, he likes that song.
Okay.
Yeah. And then he says, not it's rain. He says, it's raining men. And then Mo says, not anymore, it ain't. That's a good answer. Not anymore.
Is Ben streaming today? That's a good question.
Very unlikely, but if I do, it'll be after 9.
Yeah.
No.
Ben, are you going to stream candidates once it resumes?
Possibly. Possibly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Anything's possible. In theory, communism works.
Yeah, when is that resuming?
Then there's no date or site.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, maybe we can have it here.
There's no date. Hey, I do want to have a Norms tournament. I was thinking that if Peter didn't object, we could maybe get Grant Owen to help us run our first one.
Also, you should have a 12-hour stream. That'll learn you.
I don't know if I could do it. I guess I could do it.
Karen can go 12 hours and then some.
I do have a lot of stamina.
Heinz Superman says, how long until Queen's Gambit Part 3 gets on the YouTube?
That's a very good question.
Yeah.
Back Pinky Jim. Well, Spencer's editing a video right now. Actually, maybe he published it.
Mm-hmm.
If I had to estimate, I'd say 2 weeks.
Anonymous gave you 5 subs.
But maybe 1 week. Yay, thank you, Anonymous.
Yeah, he's the Anonymousist.
I gotta know who it is. Come on.
What?
Yeah.
It was probably me.
Thank you, Anonymous. If Grant cannot...
How can we go to dinner when you've had so many subs?
Oh, okay. Are you a FIDE arbiter? I didn't know that. Because, see, the problem is we really need a FIDE arbiter in the house. Really do, because I'd like to have, when we get back to Over the Board, well, I'll talk to you about the debate. Maybe we'll get something going there if Grant doesn't work out. But for us to run our Norms tournament, we have to have a FIDE arbiter, as Buzzard Bait obviously would know. And... FIDE arbiter.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm a local TD, and I'm dying to become a senior TD because that's my next step before becoming a FIDE arbiter. But I have to probably be the chief TD for 3 more tournaments with 50 more players before I can try to be a senior, much less than I have to get all the criteria to be a FIDE. So I don't know. Or I'm sorry, national. Oh, national arbiter, yeah.
It wasn't a rock. It was the rock Obama.
Anyway, so it's going to be a while before we have anybody at our club that has the credentials. So we're going to have to hire out. So I might talk to you about that buzzer bait. But what should we do? Oh, you got to go? Aw. Do you have time to play before you go? I could play you. Or are you leaving right now? If you're in the queue.
He said his uncle, so forth.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I got off on my little tangent about the Norms tournament.
If you got off on a tangent, maybe that's a sign you should end the stream.
Well, let's do one more. Let's do one more. And then, because we don't have to go quite
yet. Does anybody want
to
co-sign that? Yeah, no, we shouldn't leave for a while.
Let's see if you're still here.
Oh, if he's not here, he can raise his hand.
Okay, you're there. All right, let me get back over here.
Chess with Ovi challenge. What? Come on, Ovi. Yeah, the more you donate, the more money Karen has. That Thai true. Food isn't cheap.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because that's because Holden makes better calculus jokes than I do. Terrible.
I hear a noise.
Yay, anonymous gifter, 5 subs.
Yay.
Now we're level 6.
Yay.
It's never happened.
I love you, Anonymous.
Go Anonymous. But stay there.
That's so nice. And not, oh wait, it's my turn. I didn't hear the noise.
Mm-hmm.
So it wasn't really my fault. Now I lost some time. Which I did not want to lose.
Yay, you gotta give 167%.
Yeah, I'm feeling the tug of karaoke again, dare I say.
You haven't gone in a long time.
I know. I miss it so much.
Mm-hmm. Hey, somebody donated money, but I couldn't, I don't know what it was. Thanks for the donation. Can somebody in the chat say how much the donation was? I missed how much it was.
Yeah, sorry. It doesn't.
It was between $0 and $1,000.
Why does Ben look so cute?
It was $9.99. Thanks for the $9.99 donation. Was it Hans Superman or somebody else? Who donated $9.99? That's a Hans Superman kind of donation. Yay! You received a level 5 hype train emote. Wow. She can't share it because it needs another mouse to share it. 18 subs, 1,300 bits. Papa John's.
Darn, that was terrible. I didn't even see that.
Frankly, terrible. Yay, I got Fork 33 subscribed. Hooray.
It's had to be that.
I fork you, you fork me. In Soviet Russia, the road forks you. Yay, Laramie sent the book.
Laramie sent the book.
Yeah, the book by Phil Gordon on poker.
Oh.
He's one of the many Phils.
I forgot about that. Thank you. That's so
There's
nice.
Phil Locke, Phil Ivey, yeah. Phil Hamuth, etc.
Mm-hmm.
There's Ben Philip Feingold. Nice kangaroo. That is good. Kangaroo said eating hot food can damage your sense of taste. I've been to India and started listening to Phil Collins. Exactly. Truth hurts.
Yeah, now I'm like way down on time.
Mm-hmm.
This happens, it's, you know, I make the vowels, it's not going to happen, then it just does.
When playing a rapid game, I prefer the clock on my right, but it's no big deal.
Now I don't feel confident about the game. Need to catch up on time. And I'm down material. My pieces are active. Oh, wait.
It's fifth nail. Buzzard Bay using all of the excuses from, let's see, what's that movie called? Blues Brothers. Man, I can't remember anything. locusts.
This is not good for me. This is a little bit scary. Coming in on me.
Yeah, but what would Scary Terry say? Still theory.
Well, let me get over here.
That's correct, kangaroo. Oh, Jake. Stream's too noisy.
The stream's too noisy.
Mm-hmm. Too much talking. Look at Karen, always sacking the exchange.
Well, you know, I'm in a bit of trouble here. Mm-hmm. Like, get something going.
You're in rubble, or you're in Barney, to quote. Don Cheadle. Afraid to quote Don Cheadle, he might hear me.
Let me see. Can I just see this? Hey, come on now.
I'm waiting for the game to be adjourned. Pick it up tomorrow. Looks like the game God versus Damn. Followed by Oh No versus You Didn't. Stop the game, it's too exciting.
Seems like. Anyway, I just gotta get over here. It seems like maybe that wasn't actually quite correct for me to do.
Mate and won five moves in a row. That's good.
Yeah.
Then you won. Well, let's analyze.
I didn't even see it myself.
Hooray.
Oh, Ralph Wiggum looks horrified. So I just didn't see it.
All right. So that was good. Bishop d3 is not a good move.
I was so worried about my time, too. It was a perfect game. Yeah, he was just telling me about the mismate.
Yeah, here you want to you want a castle so your rook doesn't get, your bishop doesn't get pinned like rook e1.
Okay, yeah, and that's happened to me before. Thank you, bishop takes, for this sent to do.
Yeah, queen c7's risky because now he could play rook e1 or queen e2. Yeah, I thought when you play queen c7 you were going to castle queenside, and I was right. But you played a5, which doesn't go well with castling queenside.
I got my plans mixed up.
And you castle, okay. And you hung a pawn. You should definitely play b6, not knight b6. You don't want to pin your knight and rook and queen. That's bad.
Okay, I was trying to figure out which was better.
Yeah, this, because then you're not pinned everywhere.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, this is bad. And then that doesn't make any sense because your knight's pinned. So that's, you should definitely play something like c4 and try to play c5.
Mm-hmm.
And by try to play c5. Okay, so that's good. Queen e7 is weird. Yeah, you should probably start playing g5, g4, and doubling your rooks like you did.
Okay. Yeah, waited too late to do that.
And then you should do that. Mm. Okay, trading queens is good.
Yeah, GG the Rock Obama.
Man, I'm good with the mouse, except for one thing. Okay. Oh, that's good. King b8's fine. b6 is fine. King a8's good. Yeah, you could play g5, g4 here. That might be better than rook f5. Might not be. Yeah, he definitely shouldn't. Yeah. Now here, if he's going to let you sack on f3, he has to take on d5 here. c5 is really bad. It, blocks his attack. He used to take this, he could open up the C file and queen C6, take on C6, rook C1. This just blocks his attack. So that's bad. Then this was good. This was good. Yeah, now here, this is interesting.
Should I have taken the pawn on f2 with my knight?
No, this is good.
Oh, that was fun. Because I thought about that.
Right. Now, I thought you might play king g2, but I think rook e1's better. So now he's threatening rook e8, which wins. Yeah. So I'm not sure what you should do. Maybe... that's probably not good. Yeah, rook e1's a good move, actually.
Yeah, I thought it was good. Yeah. I wasn't sure what to do.
Yeah, okay. So you played knight e2, which is good if he takes it, because then you have mate. But he played here.
And then I realized I wasn't
ready. Yeah, now, so in the game, you kept allowing queen takes c6 mate. So you need to play b5 here. Or just something where he can't mate you, and then you can win on time.
I didn't see the mate.
I guess you're probably losing here, which is weird because you probably weren't losing a few moves ago. It's a blitz game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you played here, and now he has queen c6 mate the rest of the game, and he never played it, which is good.
Because
this is mate. And then he played here, and then he has mate again, and then you played here, and he has mate again. And then even after his blunder, I don't think he saw knight takes rook. He still has queen takes c6 mate, and his time ran out.
Yeah, we were both really low.
So that's good. You won on time.
Hey, yabba dabba.
But that was a very interesting game with the opposite side castling and the exchange sack and so forth. And also, you get the 300 centitudes from bishop takes.
And yes, Storm, I'm trying to be more attacking, and I do understand that sometimes that I'm making some unsound moves, trying to grow a little, change my style a little. I don't like my passive style. Well, what do you think?
That was a good stream. Yeah, you got to level 5.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Did you want to, what time did you want to leave?
Whenever we leave. Yeah.
We could probably even get there a little early. I'm just not sure about it.
Yeah.
Let me just check the situation out.
Hmm.
Man, I hate to not play you guys because you're so good. Joa and the Logic. Goodest. Yeah, I love playing Joa. And I like playing Logic.
60-30, damn.
But, you liked that sacking the exchange. Yeah, I had to get in there, Bonarici. Get in there. You were ironing.
Yeah, he was preparing for the Iron Man competition.
Really?
No.
Oh. Stop.
It's Tickle Me Elmo.
Well, no, I just didn't know anybody. I didn't know anybody ironed anymore. I do have an iron, but I try to never have to use it. I mean,
no, I thought you had an iron deficiency.
Wow. Ironic. Hey, come on. All right, let me see who's streaming.
Don't you think? A little too ironic.
No, but this person probably has. They probably just started, I bet.
Who?
Them, but they just started.
Yeah, that's what somebody said.
So, like, but then there's usually just the welcome screen.
Mm-hmm.
So, I didn't even know. Raid Hikaru. I wonder if I'm allowed to raid anybody that's banned me.
Probably not.
Yeah, I don't want to stir up trouble. Yeah, I won't raid him. I do like his stream. And, but I won't grace him with our presence. You guys can go click over there and watch him if you want, obviously. All right, we're going to raid this guy. I don't think they're streaming yet, do you?
Doesn't matter.
All right, we're gonna raid. This person might have their welcome screen on, but these are friends of ours, and they're good stream. He's a good streamer, etc. Papa John's, etc. And all the sayings. Okay, bye. Toodles, love you guys. Thank you. See you.